It's me, Monopus, and for some reason, even with everything recorded, and the only thing I had to do was the audio and putting it together, I'm still at the end of the month posting it. So again, if you didn't watch last month's video, this is a continuation of my art fight, which was last month. And I really go insano mode for the first one because I don't know what was going on, but I was like, I love this character. I love the colors. I can't understand the reference for the life of me. Every time I looked at it, it felt like I was looking at something different. I couldn't tell if that was shading or with like the purple and stuff. So I just kind of went away with my drawing and I was like, let's go. If we block out colors, if we change something, and then make all the dark colors a specific way. I really like this piece. I don't know what I did, but I was like, I love it. I love it so much. I love the way the webs are. I love that the original character has like petals on her web, I think. At least that's what I assume. I actually have like, I sit down and full recording and then I had to pause at some point and I was like, yeah, I'm fully done. And then I turned around, I came back the next day and I still had the file open and I went, no, I can do more. And I sat down for an extra half an hour to just put like last little things on and fiddle around with it. It probably wasn't necessary, but I was like, for me it is. Personally, I need to see it done this way. For my second one, oh, I loved it. I looked at the person's profile and they were like, this is my pony, Sona, and if you're looking for things to do, here's like a list of things that I'd like. And one of them was that she'd like a Melanie Martinez piece. And I love Melanie Martinez. I watched her concert when she came to Australia when I was in high school and I adored it. I'm not big on concerts. I don't like the crowds and I don't like how loud and everything it is and too much going on all at once. But when I went, you know, for the experience and oh my God, I loved it. It was so pretty. She was wonderful. I really wish I had recorded the second part. So I do like a part of it. I took my break obviously, but when I come back, I've forgotten that I'd stopped the recording. I just kept going. I just finished it. I'm happy I think I got all the line art done in the recording and like some base colors. I obviously changed some of the base colors because like they just did not work out with the rest of the piece. The art, if you are not aware, is based off Strawberry Shortcake music video where Melanie Martinez is in a really big cake in the K-12 album, because I really like the aesthetics. I know it's all like it's pastel, it's got, I don't know what that architecture is called, but I like it. It's fun, but I hate drawing it. But I was like, you know, I made up entirely. I wasn't gonna look for a proper like wall molding so that I could draw that when I could just make it up. And I put like swirls and ponies and kind of tried to put her cutie mark into it, kind of incorporated that one into the top, but I don't know if I did that well. The one after that, I don't know. It was just a really funny character. I clicked on random and it came up with Spider Among Us and I was like, well, I mean, I can't not. And considering I've been making full pieces with backgrounds and all this stuff for the most part, I was like, well, how much harder is it gonna be for me to make, like, recreate the Among Us background and the Spider-Man, the Spider Among Us kind of cover art for like a comic? I don't know why. I was giggling through my entire drawing of that. I tried to make the web, like in the reference, I think it's made up of tiny, tiny little Spider Among Us's or whatever, or is it white? I can't remember. But as you see when I draw it, I try to make it the like alarm emergency report button one, or is it the, yeah, I make it those colors essentially, like a woo, to kind of reference the whole Among Us thing. And then I'm like, oh, but it's, make it white, because it's like white. But like the white just kind of looked ick to me and I was like, I can't unsee what I'm seeing because it looks like it's coming out of his bum. Then I realized once I'd finished drawing it and I was like, I can't change it because that listen, it's really hard to draw that kind of stuff, that kind of web. The web is based off one of the comic kind of web because I like how they make it kind of twisty and turny rather than like it, instead of like a singular line. Like, honestly, if I'm drawing spiderweb stuff, I'm gonna make it a singular line, but like, I don't know, I felt like a bit more of a reference to the comics. I decided to just go against it, and I was like, if they're mad at me, then I'll accept that, but I can't make it white because it looks like it's coming out of his bum, and I don't want to. I thought I could count to a reasonable number. Spider has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 letters? S-P-I-D-E-R. Yes, 6 letters. And yet somehow when I'm making those little boxes, I'm like, yep, that's 5. Spider has 5 letters. And so you'll see me writing spider and it'll get to E and it'll just immediately be like, all right, I've missed one. I've missed a letter and I've goofed. I'm not rewriting it. I'm not good with my handwriting. And I know I had to write more after spider. My block letters, I started with a great S, great P, devolved after that, the rest of the words. Thank goodness that Among Us can just kind of look that way and it looks fine. I made a usually in that little red box is like Marvel or something. Or does it say Marvel? I don't know what it says. Hold on. Yeah, it says Marvel. Get my head all mixed up. So I was like, what if I wrote Among? Then I wrote obviously the issue number and how much it costs. Comics cost a lot in Australia. I'd know as someone who does buy comics and was just like, maybe I just buy the completed section so it's a full book and I'm not paying like a whole lot of money. I just have to search for all the things that I want to read. It's a little harder because the comic issue is obviously a lot easier to find. The next one I did was, I really loved this one. The pony itself was extremely pretty and I wanted to draw her and I was just like, I gotta. Her whole like backstory was that she's from like a timeline where the Wendigo take over and she's like a very solo pony and I was like, I want to draw her running from the Wendigo. I love My Little Pony lore with my whole chest, with my whole heart. I've recently come into claim of one of the omnibuses of the Twilight Sparkle era. I don't know. Gen 3 or something. And once again, we return to another spider sona. I really liked how I started out with this piece. I liked the composition. I was a bit fussy with the hands because one, I don't know why the hands were not working for me that day. And two, they just, I thought they looked like they were giving me the middle finger by the end of it. And I was just like, I'm begging, please don't take it that way. The composition, when I started doing the background, I feel like it's like I liked the angles and all that stuff. I took reference of a couple of the actual like Spider-Man comics and all that. Like when I was doing the sketch, it looked great, but once I put the lines down, I was like, oh no. We looking a little strange. So I just kept trying to render more and more on top of it. And I think just before I started this one, I had gotten the art of Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Cause I'd just been looking at the art of Into the Spider-Verse cause I have both those books. And I was like, oh my God, I wanna try the painterly thing. But like, I've never done a study in my life. I've never studied another art style. So I just kind of look at things and go, maybe. Maybe. I was just like, maybe I mix it with my style before ever even beginning to try another style, you know? Let's do that. I don't know why I have a habit of being like, I could follow the instructions or I could look at the instructions, pretend I know what I'm doing, and then change it to what I want. Not a great idea for most things. It's how I stuff up most things. But you know, you learn, you live and learn. And I learned that, you know, next time maybe I actually study. Like an art style before I try and incorporate it into my own art. You know, let it smoothly blend itself in with the things I learn. No, I'm a fool. I don't know, I tried to fix it by making like action lines and stuff and I was just like, that's not... I made the stuff glow and I was like blending and then I changed the background color and I was like, I liked the background color before but it just didn't blend well, but then maybe it could have blended well. I had a lot going on. With this piece, it was going on and on and I was just like, I've had enough. No, if we keep touching it, we're gonna hate it more, and the more we hate it, the less we want to like actually properly work on it. Luckily, I came away being like, it's an okay piece. It is not my best. It is not my best in the slightest, but this is Art Fight and I actually cannot redo an entire piece. Redoing parts of a piece are fine, but an entire piece, I don't think so. Not here for it. The next piece, I know I just said I don't redo pieces, but like, this is different. I'd gotten the reference of this character, this pony, and I was like, oh my gosh, I need to give her like the anime shoujo oh ho ho kind of laugh pose, and I was like, I live for it. So I was like, this pony, she's gonna be looking fire. At the time, I thought I failed, but looking back on it now, I'm like, no, I'm great. We're good for it. We're good. but the person who owned the character, literally an hour before I had submitted this character to Artfight, they had taken down the character. So I had the page already open, looking at the reference on Artfight, so it hadn't loaded for me yet. So I was just, I put the thing in, it was like, we can't find this character. And I was like, what do you mean you can't find this character? She's right here. And so I reloaded the page and they were like, sorry, this character doesn't exist anymore. So I was like, oh no. So I ended up doing the next character, which is of the same person's characters, and it's like a Bluey character. I haven't watched Bluey any more than clips. I know it's a very cute show. I know it's very wonderful because I've watched the clips, and who doesn't love little puppy things? I tried to make like it into like a fairy style, but with like thick lines. And I was like, I don't know if the character came across from the like Bluey reference to like a fairy. So I feel like I got it close enough. They didn't have a description of the character, and I was just like, well, not that I remember. And I was just like, well, this is a pose. This pose will have to do. I like the fluffy cheeks and the squish face I gave it. I love that. But I ended up posting both of these, and the person was just like, oh, well, they brought up the pony character's reference again so I could post it properly. And I was like, thank you. It was very nice of them. The next one, I'm not sure if this is a My Little Pony OC. Like, it looks like a pony, but also like an inkling. I'm not sure, but I like the design. I really need to look more at whether I can do designs or not, because I was going through the ringer with some of the design things, like all the lines everywhere and the dots. And I don't know why, but I had trouble with its hair. The hair was just a little difficult for me. I did like multiple sketches of this character, but like it's really cute. And I love the color palette with the oranges and the like accent colors of blue and like small amounts of pink. Love it. It's so cute. The squid parts, adorable. The little sad faces on its little octo thing, I love it. I did the background of like its little, I don't know, it was like a squid plushie from what I remember it had, and I was just like, I couldn't incorporate it in the actual character, but I can incorporate it in the background as a pattern. After that, I did it. I don't know, I feel like I could have done better with the next one for sure, because I did the face and I was like, stunning, I really like this. I did the body and I was like, love that. I think the part that I really didn't like was what I did with the shading. Like, it's okay, but like, to me, I look at it and it's like a bit off. Like, I don't think there's like, there's clearly one point of like, clearly one point of light. Or is there? There's multiple points of light. I don't know, something about it. Something about it got me feeling like, nah, we could have done a little better. We could have done a squizzing better. I feel like it's maybe the reds. Maybe I did something with the reds. Could have made the eyes glow more, maybe. I'm still trying to figure it out, what I done wrong with that one. Like, it looks wonderful, looks pretty. Just not sure what I could have done better. But I feel like it could have been better, that's the thing. The next one, I loved. I'm not very good at dinosaurs. I do not draw dinosaurs. I used to draw dragons, but not dinosaurs. But this one, the little pink one, was so very cute. And I don't know about the green one. I don't know what kind of dinosaurs they are. I do not know for the life of me what a dinosaur's names are, unless it's like a T-Rex or a pterodactyl and stuff. Like the very basics, not a clue. But like, I don't really have a lot to say about it. It's a very basic drawing. It's two headshots, you know. I like putting the pink on it and trying to incorporate the pink into the green, being like, oh my god, does pink even go with green? Like for a shade. Luckily, I feel like it actually blends the piece a little better together. The very last one I did was like the quickest one I've ever done, because I sketched that thing out in one and I was like, I gotta get done. I'm looking at the hours of Artfight tick down one by one, being like, oh my god, I've barely got like 20 minutes left. I gotta go. I wanna get this revenge out. And I was just like, it needs a back. I just gotta give something more to it. And I realized I'm not very good at incorporating feathers from one design to another. Because this was not, I think from what I remember, the reference is very painterly. And I was like, oh my goodness, that's not what I'm drawing though. Also, I don't understand bird anatomy. Bird anatomy, weird. I know they got wings and they got fluffy and they got beak. They got leggies. I don't know how to put them all together. I don't know what the glue is. That body part, that bean ain't working. But that was my final rundown, and I was like sitting there at the clock ticking away, and I posted that one. I was like, we got them all out. We got a solid 21 full pieces, even with my small break of being incapacitated by my teeth being removed. But thanks all for watching, and I'll see you next.